Hi friends, this is Subrat here, and in this video we are going to discuss about how we can select n number of random samples from a data frame object. So let's start. So I'll explain this with different examples so it will be clear. So first we should know which pandas function we can use to select the random sample. So sample method we can use to do this operation. So this is the full signature of a sample method. So here you can see sample method takes 6 parameters as its argument. So we'll discuss with each arguments with different examples. So first of all, let me create a data frame object called employee data frame, and inside that I'll be containing all those employee details like what is the person name, year, income, age and sex. So let us see the first example how we can implement the sample method. So if you are passing a single integer value as an argument to the sample function, then it's going to return you the same number of random samples as an output. So in this example, I have passed 3 as an argument to my sample method. Then it's going to return me the 3 random rows from my employee object. So let me execute this one more time. You will see that different rows has been returned. It's 3, 2, 1 now. If you are executing one more time also, you will get different rows has been given as an output. So if you are passing a single integer as an input to the sample method, then it's going to return you the same number of rows as an output. So let us see some other variant of my sample method. So by default, sample method going to return you each row at most once. That means there will be no duplication of rows in your output. So here you can see if you are using the sample method and you want to sample 10 number of random samples. So by default, each row will be selected at most once. So you can change that by using the replace argument. By default, replace will be false. That means there will be no duplication of rows. So in this example, you will see that by default, replace value will be false. That means there will be the no duplication of rows. So here you can see each row has occurred only one time. So that you can change by using the replace equal to true. So if replace equal to true, you are allowing your output to have duplicate rows. So in this example, I have given replace equal to true. So in this example here, you can see row 1 has occurred 3 times here. This is first, second and 3 times. That means you are allowing your output to have duplicate rows. So here you can see row 3 has occurred 2 times, row 4 has occurred 3 times. That means if you are putting replace equal to true, that means you are allowing your output to have duplicate rows. So in technical terms, it is called as rows with replacement and rows without replacement. If you are putting replace equal to true, that means you are having rows with replacement. If you are putting replace equal to false, that means you are having rows without replacement. So let us see some other variant of my sample method. So by default, each row has an equal probability of being selected. That means if you have 5 rows inside your data frame, then each row will be having 20% of probability of being selected. So you can also change this probability by using the weight argument. So to the weight argument, you can pass list, numpy array or a series as its value, but they must be of same length as the object you are sampling. So let us understand this with one example here. Suppose I have a series called SCR, and inside that I have some elements called AEIOU vowels collection. If you are sampling by using a single sample argument, it is going to give you output like this. So here each individual elements will be given 20% probability. That means every element is having equal number of chances of being selected. This probability you can change by using the weight argument. So weight argument takes a list or a numpy array or a series as its value. So here I have passed a list as its value. So inside that list, I need to specify what is the probability I want to put for individual elements. For this A element, I want to give 0.1 probability. That means 10% probability. So for E, I want to give 50% probability. That means 0.5 I need to give. So the probability value will vary from 0 to 1. So 0 being 0 probability and 1 being 100 probability. So here you can see U has been given 0.4, which means 40% probability. So this list you can pass to weights as an argument. So if you are passing this list to weights argument, then you can see E will be given 50% probability. That means E will be given highest probability among all these elements, and I and O will be given 20% probability. So in this way you can change the probability of being selected for individual elements. So let me execute this one more time. Let's see how the outputs are varying. As you have given 50% probability for the E, you can see every time you execute this statement, the chances of being selected for E is higher. So here you can see E will be selected every time here. So we'll see different variation of how we can change the probability. Suppose you are giving higher probability to the first and second element only. Here the first second element is A and E, and you are giving 0 probability to the rest of the elements. That means, so when you are sampling this series, A and E is going to select every times. So if you execute this statement, you can see that you are assigning 50% probability to the A and 50% probability to the E. So here you can see, if you execute this many times also, A and E is going to be selected. And as you have given 0 probability to the other elements, those elements will not get selected. So let us see some other variant also. Suppose you have given 0 probability to the all these elements except I. So in case of I, you have given only 10% probability. So let us execute this statement. So in this case, you can see if you are executing this statement n number of times also, I is going to get selected. So let us implement this probability concept to a data frame object. Suppose this is my employee data frame, and I have selected 5 random samples from my employee data frame. Here you can see each row will give a 20% probability of selection. That you can change by using the weight argument. So inside the weight argument, I have mentioned what is the probability of selection for each row I want. So here you can see first row is having 60% probability, second row is having 50% probability, third row is having 40%, fourth row is having 30%, and final fifth row is having 0% probability. So in this case, you will see that the fifth row will not get as an output. So if you are executing this, you will see that the row fourth is not coming as an output. So if you are executing this many times also, you will see the row fourth will not come as an output. So because you have put 0% probability to my fourth row. So in this way, you can assign probability of selection for individual elements inside a data frame or a series object. So one more variant also we can see for the sample method. Sample also allows user to sample columns instead of rows using the axis argument. In previous examples, we have seen how we can select random rows, but we can also select random columns also by using the axis argument. So by default, axis value will be 0. That means you want to randomly select rows only. So that you can change by passing 1 as its argument. So if you are passing axis as 1, then it's going to randomly select the columns. So here n equal to 1 means I want to select only one column, and x is equal to 1 means I want to select random columns only. So if you execute this, let's see what's the output we are getting. So here you can see we are getting income as only one column its output. So let's see some other variant. If you have passed n equal to 2, that means you want two number of random columns as its output. So here it has picked sex and income as its random column. So let's see some other variant of my sample method. So if you want to get same rows as an output every time, then you can use the random state argument. So to this random state argument, you can pass any integer value. So let me explain you this with one example. Suppose this is my employee data frame. So if you want to get same number of rows as an output every time, then you can use the random state argument. So to that random state, you have to pass an integer value. So this integer value can be anything. So here I have passed 0. So if you execute this many times also, then you can see that I am getting 201 as an output. So it is not changing the output. If I put random state equal to any integer value, then it's going to give same number of rows as an output. Here you can see if I'm executing this statement many times also, then it is giving me 201 as its output. So by using the random state argument, you can keep the rows as same for each execution. So one more argument my sample function take, which called fraction, FRAC. You can use percentage of rows to be returned by using the fraction argument. That means if you have 10 number of rows inside your data frame object, you can mention how many percentage of rows you want to return. If I have mentioned 50% of rows I want to return as an output, then it's going to give you 5 rows as an output. So in fraction attribute, you can mention what percentage of rows you want to get as an output. So let us see how we can use this fraction argument with one example. Suppose this is my data frame called employee data frame, and I have used fraction equal to 0.5. as in my employee data frame I have only 5 number of rows, so what is the 50% of 5 number of rows? It's coming 2.5. so we'll take a whole number only, then it's going to display me 2 rows as an output. So you can use also replace argument. So here you can put replace equal to true, that means with replacement, and also you can put replace equal to false, that means without replacement. Let us change the fraction value to 70%. I want 70% of rows as an output. Here you can see the rows count has been increased to 4 over here. So as I have put replace equal to true, that means with replacement I am getting the duplicate rows as my output. Let us change the fraction to 100%. That means I want 100% of rows as my output. So here I have put fraction equal to 1 and replace equal to false. That means I don't want any duplicate rows as my output. So friends, this is all about how we can select some random samples from my data frame object by using the sample method. I hope this concept is clear. If you guys have any doubt regarding this, you can leave a comment under my video. Thank you.